today is number 410. Please rise and join us in Praise the Lord, I believe. 410.
Thank you. God, you declare your almighty power, chiefly in showing mercy and pity. Grant us the fullness of your grace, that we, running to obtain your promises, may become partakers of your heavenly treasure. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Esther. The king and Haman went in to feast with Queen Esther. On the second day, as they were drinking wine, the king said to Esther, "What is your petition, Queen Esther? It shall be granted you. And what is your request? Even to half of my kingdom it shall be fulfilled." Then Queen Esther answered, "If I have won your favor, O king, and if it pleases the king, let my life be given me, that is my petition, and the lives of my people, that is my request. For we have been sold, I and my people, to be destroyed, to be killed, and to be annihilated. If we have been sold merely as slaves, men and women, I would have held my peace, but no enemy can compensate for this damage to the king." Then King Ahasuerus said to Queen Esther, "Who is he and where is he? Who has presumed to do this?" Esther said, "A foe and enemy, this wicked Haman." Then Haman was terrified before the king and the queen. Then Harbona, one of the eunuchs in attendance on the king, said, "Look, the very gallows that Haman has prepared for Mordecai, whose words saved the king, stands at Haman's house, 50 cubits high." And the king said, "Hang him on that." So they hanged Haman on the gallows that he had prepared for Mordecai. Then the anger of the king abated. Mordecai recorded these things and sent letters to all the Jews who were in all the provinces of King Ahasuerus, both near and far, enjoining them that they should keep the 14th day of the month Adar, and also the 15th day of the same month, year by year, as days on which the Jews gained relief from their enemies. And as for the month that had been turned for them from sorrow into gladness and from mourning into a holiday, that they should make them days of feasting and gladness, days for sending gifts of food to one another and presents to the poor." The word of God. Please stand and join me in reading Psalm 124 responsively, found in the bulletin insert or on page 781 of the Book of Common Prayer. If the Lord had not been on our side, if the Lord had not been on our side, they would have swallowed up us up alive. Then would the waters have overwhelmed us and the torrent gone over us? Then would the raging waters
have gone right over us.
Blessed be the Lord.
He has not given us over to be a prey for this deed.
We have escaped like a bird from the snare of the fowler. Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of James. Are there any among you suffering? They should pray. Are any cheerful? They should sing songs of praise. Are any among you sick? They should call for the elders of the church and have them pray over them, anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord. The prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise them up, and anyone who has committed sins will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed. The prayer of the righteous is powerful and effective. Elijah was a human being like us, and he prayed fervently that it might not rain. And for 3 years and 6 months, it did not rain on the earth. Then he prayed again, and the heaven gave rain, and the earth yielded its harvest. My brothers and sisters, if anyone among you wanders from the truth and is brought back by another, you should know that whoever brings back a sinner from wandering will save the sinner's soul from death and will cover a multitude of sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The sequence hymn is number 680, O God, our help in ages past. Would you please stand and join us in hymn 680?
Tear it out. It is better for you to end it.
somewhere in the 500s or early 400s, and it takes place in a town named Susa, S-U-S-A, which is east of Babylon. So these are people, these Jewish people, probably escaped from Israel during the Babylonian captivity, to all of the able-bodied and able-mental people away to crush the state of Israel at that time. And it probably has some importance here simply because it's a reminder that there are bad things that can really happen. Now, for us this day, this week, we've had plenty of reminders that bad things can really happen. But also can do things. Jesus is being a salesman when he tells you to cut off your hand and other things. There's a bit of exaggeration here, but he's making a point. And the point he's making is not to cut off your relationship with God. And I'm seeing the evidence in this text from Matthew, the evidence that Jesus was not the only person in his time doing the work of God. And the story is also a reflection, an echo, if you will, of the sense that Jesus had of people who knew God. They knew God through Jesus, to be sure. But they also knew God through other sources, which the Jews of that day was their understanding and relationship with God. The reading from James asks the question, are you any of you suffering? And it is rather instructive. My brothers and sisters, if anyone among you wanders from the truth and is brought back by another, you should know that whoever brings back a sinner from wandering will save the sinner's soul from death and will cover a multitude of sins. I read that because we, both individually and as a community, we have a ministry. A ministry which we practice whenever we communicate with people. We don't have to mention Jesus' name to communicate with people. us stand and say together the Nicene Creed, page 358. We believe in one God,
Father the Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally God from the Father, God from God, life from life, true God from true God, begotten, not made, from one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified at the Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again.
Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life everlasting. Amen. Oh, that's interesting. The prayers of the people today are found using form. Oh, you have two different ones. That's interesting. Yeah. Okay, we're doing that one today. Form 6, found on page 392 in the Book of Common Prayer. Wow. In peace, we pray to you, Lord God. For all people in their daily life and work, for our families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone, for this community, the nation, and the world, for all who work for justice, freedom, and peace, for the just and proper use of your creation, for the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression. For all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble. For those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy. For the peace and unity of the Church of God. For all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth. For Michael, our presiding bishop. For Rob, our bishop. And Nancy, our rector. For all Gold Star mothers and military families who have lost loved ones, and for all bishops and other ministers, for all who serve God and His church, for the special needs and concerns of this congregation, for those who support the outreach efforts of our church and community, for those for whom our prayers for healing and encouragement are asked today, Elias, Gail, Corinne, Lexith, Emily, John, Judith Ann, Richard, Lloyd, Aaron, Eileen, Pat and Eleanor, and for healing within ourselves. Please add your own prayers at this time, either aloud or silently in your hearts. Hear us, Lord, for your mercy is great. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life, for all known to us who celebrate birthdays this week, including Rebecca Osborne, Katie Peterson, Matthew Erdahl, Nancy Waller, David Greiner, Meredith Potvin, and for those celebrating anniversaries this week, including Steve and Pat Hinault, Grant and Monica Wright, Bob and Lainey McCann. Please add your own thanksgivings at this time, either aloud or silently in your hearts. We will exalt you, O God, our King, and praise your name forever and ever. We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. From our Book of Remembrance, Teresa Pepin, Terry Nazer, and Riley Wolfe, in whose loving memory the altar flowers are given. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them who put their trust in you. We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us with your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Please stand. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your words spoken through the prophets, and above all in the Word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death.
We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming in glory.
And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, descend your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with St. Matthew and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the peace. Hallelujah.
Thanksgiving. 65, saying together, Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in your sacrament of the body and blood. Send us now into the world of peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Peace of God, your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God.
I'm sorry, Shane. And now, would you please rise and join us singing the recessional hymn, number 347, Go Forth for God.